Assalamu alaikum, welcome back to my channel. This is Maha. I'm super, super excited to be back to school. My daughter is back to school. I'm back to teaching my Arabic courses and I'm back also filming these language lessons for you. Today I'm very, very excited because I have three important things to talk to you about. The first thing is I'm going to teach you a full lesson about the vocabulary that has to do something with going back to school, university, backpack and pens and everything that you need to know regarding the subject of school and going back to studying and language learning. This is the lesson, but I also want to let you know that I have decided, since it's September, like every year, and I'm a language nerd, to start learning two new languages. In order to start learning these two new languages, I went directly to iTalki. iTalki is one of the most famous language learning platform out there, which is sponsoring this video. I'm going to tell you why I used iTalki at the beginning of last year in my search of a perfect German teacher for me. I found my perfect German teacher, and maybe you can find your Arabic or Korean or Japanese teacher just like I did on iTalki. Let's get started. iTalki is a platform where you can learn any language in the world. Almost more than 150, more than 5 million students learning through this platform. So it's something huge that I also myself, as a language teacher, but also as a learner, I wanted to discover at the beginning of this year. You know, I ramble so much, so I'm going to give you the hottest points about why you should learn a language on iTalki, just like I'm going to do. So we said iTalki is a one-on-one language learning platform. So you learn with the teacher of your choice. You have an option to choose from certified teachers, which usually cost a little bit more, and community teachers, which are usually native speakers or speakers to a perfection of one language that you are willing to learn. Maybe that come from a place where they speak a certain dialect that you're interested in. In my situation, in Arabic, maybe you would love to learn Egyptian Arabic, not standard Arabic, or maybe Syrian Arabic, or Iraqi, or Sudani, or Maghribi. Yeah, so there is always a teacher for you, for the language and dialect of your choice. Of course, there's no need to say that you can find teachers from all around the world with different backgrounds, so you get to know them, you get to create friends. My German teacher became my best friend, and she happened to be from a Palestinian village. So my German teacher is a certified, qualified German teacher that is Palestinian originally, from a village that was one of my favorite, me and my grandfather. So you can build friendships with your teachers, you can click, you can choose, you have a lot of options until you find the best teacher that suits you. This is what happens on iTalki. You try, you read the feedback, you watch their trial video. By the way, when I started learning, when I started looking for my teacher, my perfect teacher that I found on iTalki, I had one trial lesson with another teacher, which I didn't like. But it cost me almost like nothing, like $4 or $5 to have this 1 hour lesson with her. Then I decided, no, okay, I still learned something, but I didn't click with her. That's why I moved on my research and eventually I found the best teacher that I could ever have that I love and I say hi to. So on iTalki, you can study at your own pace. You decide, today I'm going to have 2 hours, next week I want to have 3 hours, at your own pace without worrying about fixed schedules. Yeah, you don't have to pay for membership. You pay on the go for the lesson that you decide with your teacher. No money to spend on learning a language. There is a free iTalki community. You can go there and share your feedback, share your questions with the whole iTalki community. iTalki, you go there, you choose the language you want to learn. The whole website is very easily put, colored and big and everything is well guided. You choose the language teacher that you want. You try one lesson. You can go to the community for free if you don't have money. You can start learning any language in the world. I will let you know now the languages that I've decided to learn. So there's this singer that I got so much into his music lately. He's from Arab origin, but is French. He sings in French. He sings in Italian because he lived in Italy, and he sings in Arabic. He takes songs and he remixes them. So I decided I'm going to learn French because of what? Because I love the music and I've always loved. I even started learning a few years ago French, but then I got pregnant and everything, you know, I didn't have any more time. It's September, I have time, I have iTalki, I have a lot of possibilities to find the discounted teachers. So I'm going to start learning French and understand all his songs. I admire him because he speaks all these languages together and he sings in the languages and he puts subtitles in English, so I recommend you go watch. That's a free publicity for Tawsin. I'm going to learn Spanish. I need to learn Spanish. I'm inshallah going to start working with Spanish universities. So I need to learn Spanish for work, and I'm going to do this, since it's very similar to Italian, I'm going to do this through iTalki. So I will keep you updated on my iTalki experience in the following videos. But remember that September 2021, Maha started learning these two languages, French and Spanish. And without further ado, let's go back to the lesson. All right, so this lesson is going to be a little bit quicker than normal because I've rambled a lot. Let's talk about things that have to do with school. Yeah, with school and university. Let me get my something and then I'll let you know why. I'm back! So I brought some things here that I want to show you in order to complete this list of vocabulary regarding school. Let's start off with the word school. School in Arabic we say madrasa, madrasa. University we say jami'a, jami'a. School is madrasa and dars is lesson. Dars is lesson, darasa is to study, madrasa is where we study, which is school. I'm not going to make this lesson too long because it's going to be too much vocabulary and grammar, but when you add ma to the word, for example, darasa is to study, and when you add ma to make it become madrasa, ma prefix indicates the place where the action is getting is being made. So darasa is to study, madrasa is where we study, hence school. Kataba is the verb to write. Maktab, it's where we write. So it means desk. And maktaba, feminine, it means library, where we find the kitab. Library or bookshop. So let's go back. School is madrasa. University is jami'a. To study is darasa. Lesson is dars. And kataba is to write. Maktab is desk, where we write. This is kitab, kitab, book, kitab. Sorry. Student, we say talib, talib. You for sure heard of the Taliban this last month. Taliban, it's the word talib, student, and the suffix an, it means two. So Taliban in Arabic, in Arabic, it means two students. It means something else regarding this, the group Taliban that we hear in the news, but that's not Arabic. That's Pashtun, the language spoken in Afghanistan and maybe some part of Pakistan. So the an there in the Talib, Taliban, it's the plural. So I think the meaning of Taliban in that language, it means the students. In Arabic, if you say Talib, it means one student. Taliban, anything that ends with an is two. So Talib, one. Taliban, two students. Yeah, not a bad word, simply two students. One student, talib, plural of students. You are my tulab, tulab. Now let's get to the interesting parts that we find in a school that I had to prepare for my daughter Layla. Now I'm going to teach you words that are sometimes colloquial. So from my dialect, colloquial Arabic, Palestinian Shami dialect, not necessarily standard Arabic, because we don't use a lot of these words in standard Arabic. This is called maqlama. In my dialect, it's ma'lami. We don't pronounce the qa. Maqlama, it is something that contains the qalam. Yeah? Maqlama, the place where there are qalam. Qalam is pen. Yeah? Now we have two words for pen. We have the normal pen. Normal ink pen, we call it qalam hibr. Qalam hibr, which I don't have here, but you understood. This is, for example, qalam hibr. I know it's not ink, it's a colored, but anyways, qalam hibr is the normal pen. And this is qalam rasas. That means pencil. Qalam hibr, that's ink, normal pen. And qalam rasas, it means pencil. Anyways, this is qalam, and whatever pen it is, you don't have to specify the type, it's called qalam. And the container that contains the qalam, it's called maqlama. It's feminine, maqlama. This is called mistara, mistara. Ruler in English? Yeah, I forgot the names even in English. This is mistara. Along with, in the maqlama, we can find mimha. Something that maha, maha means to erase. This is mimha. Also this is mimha. Yeah? Why? Because it comes from the verb maha, to erase. Mimha, eraser. Another thing that we can find is mibra. Maybe you don't know. You cannot see well. This is a mibra. Mibra, because the verb bara is to sharpen, and mibra is the sharpener. Mibra. What else do we have here? We have alwan. Qalam mulawan, or pen that is colored, but you can say alwan. These are colors. Yeah, alwan. Ooh, this is in Arabic, in Palestine, we say dibbiq. Comes from dibbiq. Stick. Yeah, glue. We call it dibbiq. And if you speak Palestine Arabic, it's easier. It's only dibbiq. All right, what else? Notebook. Notebook, we call it daftar. Daftar. Our bag or backpack, we call it shanta. Shanta. Some other countries, Arab countries, they call it haqiba. Haqiba. But we call it mainly in the standard Arabic shanta, feminine. Yeah, shanta, where you can put everything, the maqlama, the kitab, the what is this? I forgot, the ruler. The qalam, the mimha, the mibra, and the dibiq, and al-alwan, all in the shanta, and the mistara. Whiteboard, we say lawh. Lawh, even if it's not white, it's still lawh. And what else we find in the madrasa? I think that's it. I think we have, of course, without al-mudarris or al-mudarrisa, we have no school. Mudarris is the teacher. Mudarrisa is me, female teacher. Yeah, mudarrisa. All right, that's it for now. These are like the most important vocabulary regarding going back ila al-madrasa. Al-rujua ila al-madrasa. Ana raja'tu ila al-madrasa. I came back, I went back to school, which means ana al-mudarrisa, teaching school, not going back to school. Ibnati raja'at ila al-madrasa. My daughter went back to school. And أنا مبسوطة, أنا سعيدة. I hope you like this vocabulary lesson quickly, but I hope you will take the challenge and start learning a new language also with me on italki. I will keep you updated on my French and my Spanish. Yeah? All right. Wish me good luck. بالنجاح. And I wish you, all of you, to my طلاب, students, بالنجاح. Best of luck and بالتوفيق. Good luck. And I will see you in the following Arabic lesson with me, Maha, here on my channel. يلا. مع السلامة. Bye.